Park 3. From that day onwards, it was a celebration time for all the tigers inhabiting Prathivandapuram. The state banned tiger hunting by anyone except the Maharaja. A proclamation was issued to the effect that if anyone dared to fling so much as a stone at a tiger, all his wealth and property would be confiscated. The Maharaja vowed he would attend to all other matters only after killing the 100 tigers. Initially, the king seemed well set to realize his ambition. Not that he faced no dangers. There were times when the bullet missed its mark. The tiger leaped upon him and he fought the beast with his bare hands. Each time it was the Maharaja who won. At another time, he was in danger of losing his throne. A high-ranking British officer visited Prathivandapuram. He was very fond of hunting tigers and fonder of being photographed with the tigers he had shot. As usual, he wished to hunt tigers in the Prathivandapuram, but the Maharaja was firm in his resolve. He refused permission. "I can organize any other hunt. You may go on a boar hunt, you may conduct a mouse hunt, we are ready for a mosquito hunt, but tiger hunt, that's impossible." The British officer secretary sent word to the Maharaja through the Diwan that Dadure himself did not have to kill the tiger. The Maharaja could do the actual killing. What was important to Dadure was photographed to himself holding the gun and standing over the tiger's carcass. But the Maharaja would not agree to this proposal. If he relented now, what would he do if other British officers turned up for tiger hunts? Because he prevented a British officer from fulfilling his desire, the Maharaja stood in a danger of losing his kingdom itself. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberations over this issue. As a result, a telegram was dispatched forthwith to a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta. "Send samples of expensive diamond rings of different designs." Some 50 rings arrived. The Maharaja sent the whole lot of British officers to Good Lady. The king and the minister expect the Duraisani to choose one or two rings and send the rest back. Within no time at all, the Duraisani sent her reply, "Thank you very much for your gifts." In 2 days, a bill for 3 lakh of rupees came from the British jewelers. The Maharaja was unhappy that though he had lost 3 lakh of rupees, he had managed to retain his kingdom. Part 4. The Maharaja's tiger hunt continued to be highly successful. Within 10 years, he was able to kill 70 tigers, and then an unforeseen hurdle brought his mission to a standstill. The tiger population became extinct in the forest of Prathivandapuram. Who knows whether the tigers practiced birth control or committed harakiri or simply ran away from the state because they desired to be shot by British and Suli. One day the Maharaja sent for the Diwan Sahib. "Aren't you aware of the fact that 30 tigers still remain to be shot down by this gun of mine?" he asked, brandishing his son's gun. Shuddering at the sight of the gun, the Diwan cried out, "Your Majesty, I am not a tiger. Which idiot could call you a tiger? No, and I am not a gun. You are neither tiger nor gun. Diwan Sahib, I summoned you here for a different purpose. I have decided to get married." The Diwan began to babble even more. "Your Majesty, I have 2 wives already. If I marry you..." "Don't talk nonsense. Why should I marry you? What I want is a tiger." "Your Majesty, please think it over. Your ancestors were married to the sword. If you like, marry the gun. A tiger king is more than enough for the state. It doesn't need a tiger queen as well. The Maharaja gave a loud crack of laughter. I'm not thinking of marrying either a tiger or a gun, but a girl from the ranks of human beings. First, you may draw up statistics of tiger population in the different native states. Next, you may investigate if there is a girl I can marry in the royal family of a state with a large tiger population. The Diwan followed his order. He found the right girl from a state which possessed a large number of tigers. Maharaja Jung Jung Bahadur killed 5 or 6 tigers each time he visited his father-in-law. In this manner, 99 tigers' skin adorned the walls of the reception hall in the Pratibandhapuram Palace. Thank you.